स्ट्रेट नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेज आर दोज फोर्सेज विच एक्ट फ्रॉम अ डिस्टेंस. सो वी लर्न अबाउट इट दैट नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्सेज फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स वेयर अ मैग्नेट कैन अट्रैक्ट एन आयरन पीस फ्रॉम अ डिस्टेंस. नाउ वी कम टू अनदर टाइप ऑफ नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स विच इज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स. इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स द वर्ड इज मेड अप ऑफ टू थिंग्स इलेक्ट्रो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड स्टैटिक. द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विच इज एट रेस्ट इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक एंड द फोर्स डिवेलप्ड इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स. एन एक्टिविटी इज देयर टेक अ प्लास्टिक स्ट्रॉ एंड कट इट इन टू टू इक्वल पीसेज. नाउ सस्पेंड वन ऑफ द पीस फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ अ टेबल विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ पीस ऑफ थ्रेड एंड होल्ड अनदर पीस ऑफ स्ट्रॉ. So that means you are taking two straws, a pieces of two straws, and then you hang them. Bring the and one of the piece which you have held in your hand, you have to rub it. Now when you rub it, it will get charged. Bring the rubbed end of the straw near the suspended straw. The straw which is hanging with a thread is suspended freely, and you bring a straw which you have rubbed. So when you rub it, it will get charged. The moment you bring it near, what will happen? It will attract the straw which was not rubbed. Now rub the free end of the suspended piece. First, the straw which you have rubbed, it attracted the straw which was hanging with a thread which was not rubbed. Now you have to rub the suspended straw also. That means now both the pieces of one straw which is in your hand which you have rubbed and charged, another piece of straw which is hanging by a thread that is also rubbed and it is charged. Now bring both the straws together. What do you think will happen? Both the straws are made of same material and they are rubbed by same material. So because you have rubbed it with paper, so both of them will have same charge. And what we will see? We will see that both the straws repel each other. So they both push against each other, but they do not come in contact. So this is an example of non-contact force which acts. So the straw is said to have attracted. It acquires an electrostatic force. Because of this, the two pieces of straw, one is in the hand and one is hanging, they are pulled towards each other because they are having, they will be attracted towards each other when they have opposite charge. So anyway, here we are not dealing about charge, we are dealing about the force. So the force which develops and makes the two straws move towards each other or move away from each other is called electrostatic force. The force comes into play when we rub them, when they are charged. So the bodies are said to get charged, and this type of force which is developed due to rubbing is called electrostatic force. This is an example of non-contact force. The next non-contact force is gravitational force. Why do you think gravitational force is non-contact? Because the earth pulls objects which are lying on it also, as well as which are not on it also. So we know about it that gravitational force is the force of gravity which pulls objects towards the earth. So objects which are not lying on the earth, when you throw a stone up, it comes back to the earth. This happens because of gravitational force. So when you toss the coin, when you hold the coin in your hand and you rub it, you throw it up, it will go up and then it will fall down. So we know this happens. This happens because of gravitational force. The coin is pulled towards the earth because of gravitational force of the earth, and this force acts. The force of gravity is called, it is an attractive force. It attracts objects towards itself. It does not repel. The force of gravity acts on all objects. We know it. The force of gravity acts on all of us all the time, without being aware of it. We don't know that gravity is acting on things around, but it is acting every time. So example they have given, there are many other examples. Water flows towards the ground. When you throw a water, it moves from one place to another. This happens because of gravity, and the water will move only when one place is at high level, another is at low level. So gravity is not the property of the earth alone. Every object in the universe whether small or large, exerts a force on every other object. This is called the gravitational force. Gravitational force does not mean only gravity of the earth. Gravitational force is the gravitational force of attraction. This law you will read in 9th class. It was given by Newton, which is called Newton's law of gravitation. His law states that every two objects in the universe are attracted towards each other by a force which is called the gravitational force. So this gravitational force is being taught here, and it is not the gravitational force of the earth. It is the gravitational force which acts between any two bodies, whether they are of the earth, whether they are outside the earth. It could be two tables, it could be two, any two objects. So they have some force of attraction which pulls them towards each other. Now the question arises, if they are pulled, then why don't two chairs which are kept near go and stick to each other? So this happens, this was explained by Newton, that this is because of the gravitational force, and this happens because of the size of the object. Two objects which will have a very big size, they only will be pulled towards each other, like the size of the earth. Earth and moon are pulled towards each other because of their size. Objects which we see around us, they are not of big size, therefore they do not attract or they stick to each other. After force, we come to the next part of the chapter, which is pressure. In class 7th, you have learned that strong winds during a storm or a cyclone can blow away even the rooftops. You have seen it around, that when winds blow at a high speed, some of the things fly away, even the roofs of some houses fly away. You have also learned that winds and cyclones are caused by the differences in pressure. So try to push, that is example of air pressure. Now here there is an activity which you have, all of you must have done someday. Try to push a nail into a wooden plank by its head. That means you are not using anything. Try to push a nail into a wood using your hands. Will you be able to do it? You will not be able to do it. Why? But when you do it with the help of a hammer, you are able to push the nail easily. Try now to push the nail by a pointed end. That means now there are two ways. Either you push the nail with your hand, it will not go easily. Now you try to push the nail from its head, from the point, not from the pointed end, from the flat end. It will not go inside the wood. You will not be able to push the nail in either of the two cases. We will get to know why does this happen. Try when we try to cut vegetable with a blunt and a sharp knife, which one can cut easily? All of us know that a sharp knife will be able to cut the vegetable easily, and a blunt knife will not be able to cut the knife, will cut the vegetable easily. Do you get the feeling that why do you think this happens? The area over which the force is applied when we try to apply force on a knife and try to cut vegetable from a blunt area, the area of the knife is more. So it does not cut. But when we cut using a sharp knife, the area of the sharp end of the knife is less. So there is something to do with area. So this is called pressure. Pressure is equal to force acting per unit area. For pressure is equal to force per unit means force divided by pressure, force divided by area. So pressure is equal to force upon area. Here we are dealing with perpendicular forces which act on every object. Note that the area is in the denominator. Since pressure is equal to force upon area, area is in the denominator, force is in the numerator. So we are dividing force by area. So if you are dividing by area and area is a small number, suppose force is a big number and area is a smaller number. So what will happen? Smaller is the area, larger is the pressure. That means if you are dividing by a small number, the answer will come more. Whereas if you divide, that is if you replace area with a bigger number, then the answer will come small. You can understand it with an example. Like pressure is equal to force, suppose force is 4 and area is 2. So what is the answer? 4 upon 2 is 2. Now if force is equal to 4 and area is equal to 5. What do you think? The answer will come more than 2 or less than 2? Obviously, the answer will come less than 2, the answer which we got earlier. So, if the numerator is big and the denominator is small, the answer is pressure is equal to more. If the numerator is small and the denominator is big, that means if the force is less and the area is more, then the pressure is less. So, the smaller is the area, higher is the pressure. That means if the denominator is small, pressure will come, answer will come more. The area of the pointed end of the nail is smaller. Since the nail has pointed end which is smaller than the bead, so same force produces a pressure sufficient to push the pointed end of the nail into the wooden. So we get the answer, why does the pointed end of the nail go into the wood? Because the pointed end is having less area. Less area means pressure will be divided. Pressure is equal to force upon area, which is less. So when you divide by a smaller number, pressure comes more. If you divide by a bigger number means when the area is more. When the area is more, the pressure will be what? Less. Explain how why shoulder bags are provided with the broad straps and not the strap. This is an explanation. You all have got bags. Why your bags, which your school bags, have got broad straps? The bag when you put on your shoulder, why are the straps so broad? Why are they not thin like rope? So the answer is same answer as of the nail. The area of the strap is more, so it puts less pressure on your shoulders. If you carry a plastic polythene bag with weight, something inside, it causes pain in your hand. Why does it cause pain? Because the area of the handle of the plastic bag is less. So when the area is less, pressure is more. Similarly, there are many other examples where pressure is explained based on the area and the force. So objects, you have understood that objects which have more area, the pressure will be, when the area is more, the pressure will be less. And when the area is less, the pressure will be more. Likewise, there are many other examples which you can understand where the area decides the pressure acting on an object.